We're joined today by Dr. Deborah Kuhn-Brewley. Dr. Brewley is the director of the MSN program at Olivet Nazarene University. She's here to share some of the innovative ways her program has integrated RealDX into its curriculum. Thanks, Deb, for taking some time with us today.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
So, Deb, could you give us a brief history of your educational background and path to your current role?
Sure. After receiving my bachelor's in nursing and passing boards, I worked in the hospital setting, mostly on orthopedic floors and also in the unit manager roles. I worked that way until I was in my 40s. And, well, actually on my 40th birthday, I started my master's degree courses. And after I finished my master's, I was advised to go straight ahead and get my PhD, which I did at UIC in nursing sciences. After my PhD, I began to teach. I taught at two different universities, mostly medical surgical courses, as well as teaching research, which was a great love of mine. After I had taught those courses, I was asked to teach in the graduate level, and I taught research at the graduate level as well as other courses, and then was asked to start creating courses for the master's degree. So once Olivet heard about that, they recruited me to come as the MSN program director at Olivet, and I was right back where I started with my baccalaureate degree. So I've been here for 4.5 years, and I have learned so much, and RealDX has been a big part of that.
Well, thank you for that, Deb. Could you tell me a little bit about your program, the underlying conceptual framework, how it's structured, are there different tracks?
Sure. We are a faith-based university. We have a motto of education with a Christian purpose. We believe in excellence at all levels, but particularly at the graduate level, I feel like. And we have three tracks in the MSN program. They are education, leadership management, and family nurse practitioner. Most of our students are family nurse practitioner students.
So how did you first learn about RealDX?
Well, I always am looking for new programs, new apps, new everything. And I received an email from David Spiro with a demonstration video, watched it, and was just thrilled that we might be able to use this in our school. And I worked for almost a year getting other people to watch it with me. And David actually did another demonstration with us live. And everybody was so blown away by that. They were thrilled with the idea, and they were all on board. Once they saw it, they loved it and wanted us to get it at Olivet.
Wow, that's really wonderful for us to hear. Thank you for sharing that. So tell folks a bit about what we're going to see now.
Okay, since we are an online program, we need things that work to engage students right away in the online courses. Since there isn't a teacher right there with them, helping them to learn at the level that we want them to learn. So first, let me say that the vignettes that we're going to watch are sample students, and they were filmed at our production studio at Olivet. So in Advanced Patho, our students are initially able to view the assigned video with the first drawer enabled for vital signs and demographic information. Then the students work in groups to create a differential diagnosis for that video. After they post that, the drawer is enabled for them to see the differential diagnosis that the healthcare provider actually had for that patient. So then they see that the differential diagnosis, they see that if their idea of which diagnosis is appropriate is amongst those, and then they have to provide a diagnosis with a rationale for that patient. So they post that in the LMS, the learning management system, which we use Canvas. So after they've done that, the next week, they get to see what the diagnosis was, and they work together in groups collaboratively to create a treatment plan. So this includes pharmacological, non-pharmacological treatments, as well as referrals and patient family education. after they've submitted their treatment plans, then they get the chance to look at all the additional wonderful information that RealDx gives for about that diagnosis. And they get to see everything that's there then. And so they also get at that chance the ability to see all of the assigned case studies. There's three case studies assigned in each class, and so for three different groups. But now they get to see everybody's, so they get to just run right through them and learn in an even quicker manner than when they were working so hard to figure out what the diagnosis was and what the treatment plan should be. They do often go to Benner Library, which is our library, in order to use up-to-date. We try to use as many resources as we can, and they are able to use up-to-date as well as other resources in order to write their treatment plans. And we have found that the students do not seem to have any problems with RealDx right from the start. They just enjoy learning from real patient videos.
So tell me, Deb, what have been some of the benefits you've seen from faculty and students in using it in this way?
Well, we've seen increased engagement right from the get-go with our students. They are able to see the patients, and they feel like it's almost like a little mini office visit. And they get to also see all of these drawers as they open at various times as we enable them. And that way, they move through the case study in a specific order and in a specific way, so that they can feel like they're really getting into the meat of the case study, but in a more intentional way. And also the faculty members can engage with the students better, we find, because they're able to point to a specific time in the video, or they're able to point to a specific drawer that was opened that lets the student know where they might have gone off track, or where they did a really good job of seeing this fairly small thing that was said, and that they caught it, and that was a wonderful thing to do. So both students and faculty seem to be more engaged now.
So Deb, let's take a look at another example of your students. Tell me what we're about to see.
Well, in health assessment, we actually use it in a different way. In the past, in pathophysiology and pharmacology, they were in group settings for their postings. Their postings were done with groups. They worked in synchronous and asynchronous ways in order to get the correct postings. However, with health assessment, they're really on their own. They are assigned a video, and then they are to look at the video, and now they're expected to create a soap note. So they aren't really shown the treatment plan, but they are given all of the subjective and objective information is there, and a lot of the labs, the procedures that have been done, all of those drawers are enabled so that they can create a soap note on this visit. We call it an episodic visit in health assessment. So they get to learn how to do soap notes on real patients before they get into the practicum setting, which we have found is helping them immensely to do adequate soap notes.
And has there been any evidence about how it's impacting students' conceptual understanding or other performance outcomes that you're seeing?
Well, actually, this is fairly new for us. We have just started with this new curriculum, and so we have only seen one or two classes go through, and we haven't really been able to adequately judge and do statistics on their conceptual understanding. But I'm getting excellent anecdotal information. One of my students said, I'm going to read from where I have it. I feel like I am actually learning something I will use as an FNP. I'm learning these things right away in my program. So you can hear the excitement in their voice when they tell us about how they enjoy using this program. And so I really think that even though we're fairly new to it, We're using it in a way online to get the students super engaged, and that I believe it is going to impact their conceptual understanding. I know that they seem to be doing a better job on their RealDX case studies than they were doing originally on their written case studies.
Well, that's really interesting for us to hear that you are noticing a little bit of a performance difference, and I'm sure there's a research study in here somewhere. How else has your program leveraged the real patient video cases in your curriculum? You have another example for us.
Yes, I do. We decided that our F&P students needed to have more than just a written tests in order to tell if they were adequately diagnosing their students, I mean their patients. So therefore, we decided to keep only certain cases for pathophysiology, pharmacology, and health assessment. And all the rest of the 700 plus videos are open for the F&P faculty to use for authentic assessments in their F&P courses. So they've got all of those great case studies for all the lifestyle, the lifespan. So they use the proper ones for children's health, for women's health, and also for acute, adult, and geriatric courses. And in this way, we are finding that our students are able to feel like, okay, I already know this technology because I've used it in pathophysiology and pharmacology and health assessment, but now the technology is not going to limit me from being able to answer questions on a test appropriately. So they're able to move right into it. We expect the students to say that they are learning better from this. We actually have not started with the F&P exams yet, but that's our goal, is to move forward with that.
Wonderful. And, you know, we're looking forward to maybe seeing a little more as you continue to come up with other great ways to utilize RealDX. You know, my hope in capturing this is that the people watching are either considering RealDX for their program, or maybe they've already started exploring adding other teaching modalities or thinking about other ways they might be able to utilize it. And so I wonder if you have any thoughts or advice for them around how to best incorporate these cases into your curriculum, and, you know, how to lead that change in your organization, you know, any best practices you may have learned or anything to help people get over hurdles that you've already made over.
Well, I must say, we are not using RealDX the way I envisioned it when I first heard about it. In fact, we're not even using it the way I first envisioned making it happen when we were creating our courses. But it was really an iterative process, and we actually found the right way to use RealDX for the specific course topics. And so therefore, we found that we were, for example, I thought the course creators in pharmacology would use RealDX the same way we were using it in pathophysiology. And once they got into it, they said, no, that's not the way we want to use it. We want to create these second time visits that they can base their original video case study off of and see how the patient would react differently according to whatever scenario we choose. So there's a lot of different ways that I'm sure that we didn't even think of that you could use RealDX. And I just think it's fascinating how one can take this product and use it in so many different ways. Because when we started, I would have never dreamed that we would use it in four different ways. But we are. And it's working for our totally online program. And it seems to be that our students are enjoying it in all the different ways that we use it. And they just have accepted these new teaching strategies when they're based off of RealDX, because they really like that product. So anyway, I'm sure that whoever is looking at this video will find new ways to use it that I didn't think of, but you will think of other ways that will best fit your program once you get into trying to use it the best way possible.
Thank you, Deb, so much for that advice. I know that for other people, you know, it's always great to have had the opportunity to hear from people who've been using it and have, you know, taken some time to really give consideration to the variety of use cases that, you know, that people are coming up with along the way. So please let me just take a moment and again say thank you for giving us a little bit of your time today and for sharing this wonderful footage that you captured at Olivet. We really truly appreciate, you know, the ongoing collaboration with your program and look forward to what you have offered for us in the future. So thank you again.
Thank you. And do let me say that I have found RealDX to be very good at giving us what we need when we need it. So I think the collaboration is exactly the right word to use in this case. And so thank you for letting us use your program. And thank you for all these wonderful video case studies that our students are able to see.
Thank you, Dr. Brulee.